These stories are inspired by the actual case files of the Office of Scientific Investigation and Research.
Claudia, did you hear something?
Hear what? You had too much wine, Miguel.
A sound. In the living room. Listen. Somebody's out there.
Is it?
I don't know.
Be careful.
He's like some kind of shadow.
Diego!
Go call the police. Right away.
Scotophobia, fear of the dark. In this age, fear of the dark seems a primitive neurosis, a throwback to a time of superstition and unreason. I mean, really, isn't darkness just the absence of light? But what if absence of light becomes something more? What if it becomes a darkness visible, an almost living, growing, absolute form, threatening to consume our homes, our town, our world?
File number 77110. Case manager Curtis Rollins. Initial case log. Federal and local authorities have placed this complaint at the highest security level. Our team is proceeding to the site of this phenomenon.
The initial police reports are fairly inconclusive.
What about the advanced video footage of the site that Professor Alvarez sent us?
It doesn't reveal much. So far, there's no rational explanation for the phenomenon. Note how it appears to be cut off by the floor. It seems to originate under the house and then project up through the floor.
And the professor who shot this footage didn't offer any theories?
Everything from a bizarre low-lying cloud formation to the discovery of neutrinos to some form of black hole on Earth. It all adds up to a dense lack of light reflection and no apparent cause.
You know, I once did a paper on photosynthesis, and we used to run experiments trying to reduce photon reflection. It's basically impossible to simulate.
Alvarez and his students reached only one definite conclusion.
And that was?
It appears to be growing.
Dr. Rollins. Buenos dias, Alejandro Alvarez.
Professor, nice to put a face to the name. We've been reviewing the footage you videotaped.
Quite incredible, isn't it?
You could say that.
This is so, forgive me, indescribable, inexplicable. Total lack of photoreflection, unlike anything I have ever seen or heard of.
We're going to begin with interviews and hopefully get a sense of what we're up against before we go inside.
I was so afraid that Diego would be swallowed up by it. Never in my life have I seen such a thing. Total blackness. Why did it attract him? Of all of us. He's just a little boy.
No, it made no sound. None at all. Just a dark wall spreading up from the floor. Anything that went into the darkness was gone. Without a trace. Anything. Why has this happened to my home? To my familia?
No, I cannot tell you.
Out here, we don't get very many complicated investigations. Senior Richard showed my partner and I to the room where the disturbance was. I have been an officer of the law for 15 years, but nothing could have prepared me for what I saw. Huge blackness, like something alive. When I shone my flashlight at it, no light was visible through it at all. Sir, I have seen many things in my time, but this defies description.
Testimony from the witnesses is consistent across the board. This event, to them, defies comprehension.
Yes, their stories all seem to match. They all describe a growing wall of blackness impenetrable by light.
And testing found no toxicity or biocontamination in any of them.
That's a safety precaution. The Richter family will be moved from their house indefinitely.
Curtis, have we determined an initial case objective on this?
The Argentine government has requested identification and termination of phenomenon. In the strongest possible terms, they want this thing gone.
What, just like that? We don't even know what it is. Can't we just wait until we know a little bit more about it?
I know it seems premature, but we don't have much choice. They perceive this complaint as a threat. Unless we can find a way to identify and control it, we have to consider its termination.
Great.
Comp check, this is Rollins.
10-4, I copy loud and clear, Curtis. Visuals coming through cleanly.
We're inside and proceeding to the event site.
Any irregular readings?
Negative. Get ready, everyone. Let's proceed with caution. You have a visual?
It's totally opaque. No light penetration at all.
What are we picking up on the scans?
Minimal readings. Displacement margins are inconclusive. There's no chemical components, no measurable mass. It's almost beautiful. Perfect.
Peter, keep your distance. Are you reading anything out of the ordinary?
Nothing. Except... confirmed. It's getting bigger. These are the results from the geodetic surveys, as well as the geothermic and geomagnetic environmental scans within a 100-kilometer radius. They all indicate a large, growing black mass in the vicinity of the Richler Villa.
Still nothing conclusive on a possible point of origin.
Do you know, I think we ought to send in a remote probe, see what kind of direct data we can get from within the mass itself.
I agree. Set it up for 1,600 hours. The Argentine government is anxious to see some progress.
All right, let's keep going. Okay. Visuals are up, sensors online.
Anything happen yet?
Still hazmat. No tox traces, no abnormal concentrations of energy fields, nothing even slightly unkosher. All right, everybody set? Probe entering the phenomenon in 3, 2, 1. Probe has entered the anomaly. No visuals at all. Readings are fluctuating.
We have a problem. Something's disrupting the signal.
Is it a malfunction? Probe system's down. We've lost telemetry.
bring it back.
I can't. It's gone.
This region has a history of geophysical and environmental phenomena, none related in any way to this particular anomaly.
Keep digging. But be subtle about it.
Curtis. I want to take a team in.
Into the mass. Peter, we just lost a probe in there.
We need answers.
We can't afford to lose any investigators.
Well, fine, I'll go by myself.
There's no evidence we can maintain contact with
you. Or
that
we can get you out once you've got in there.
Look, I'll suit up in the full gear. According to the readings, it shouldn't be a
problem. There are no readings, Peter. It's too risky. We should just send in another probe.
Right, and then we'll just lose it again. Look, I've logged hundreds of hours in toxic environments. It won't be a problem. The gear will protect me, trust me. Curtis.
The ultimate threat this phenomenon poses overrides any of our personal safety. You sure about this?
Hey, I didn't join up to play it safe. Well, let's get going.
I don't know if you're being brave or just stupid.
Tasha, stop pondering the imponderables. You're back in a flash.
If you sense anything strange, zero gravity, vacuum pull, anything, you get the hell out of there, okay?
Relax. This is the cool stuff scientists get to do.
Axon, do you copy?
10-4, copy loud and clear.
Visuals are good. We'll keep your vitals online. Any elevated readings and you're out of there.
Understood.
Peter, do you copy?
I'm still online.
Peter, answer us.
Affirmative. This radio transmission's clean enough.
What do you see?
Nothing. No depth perception. Light waves aren't even registering in the environment. Can't read the instruments.
Any sign of the probe?
I'm sorry. I can't see myself. I'm coming out. Sorry, Curtis.
Satisfied, Peter?
Sir, I think you should see this. It's an uplink transmission. It's being rerouted to us from headquarters via satellite.
They found the same phenomena in China.
Same configuration as ours.
Curtis, are we talking about an outbreak?
No, not exactly. Perhaps something much worse.
What do you mean?
Watch up number one. This new occurrence is here, in Ningbo, Zhejiang province. Ningbo is the exact polar opposite to Huhoi, which opens up the possibility that instead of two separate occurrences, we could be dealing with
one very large, very dangerous phenomenon.
Señor Rollins, if I may ask, your investigation, how does it proceed?
Slowly. We are trying everything in our power to understand this manifestation, but it's a little frustrating.
Perhaps this event is something we are not meant to understand.
Why is that?
You have brought all your scientific knowledge here and have found nothing to explain it.
These things take time. We haven't done everything we can yet. Believe me, we will find out what this thing is.
And you won't stop until you do, will you?
No, senor. We won't stop.
I admire your passion, senor. That you believe you can find the truth.
And you don't.
I believe there are some things we simply cannot know.
File number 77110. Case log update. A Bravo team has been dispatched to study the second occurrence. They will link their investigation to ours.
Established operations here. Data seems to be identical to Alpha Site. Phenomenon growing at the same rate.
22.6 centimeters per hour and increasing exponentially.
According to our numbers, Jujuy will be consumed within 7 days.
It's still growing.
Our projections match Alpha. 7 days to 88% of Ningbo region in darkness.
Continue monitoring the anomaly. Next contact in 12 hours. Roger. Alpha team up. We can't let this phenomenon spread.
The stakes are high. Zero photosynthesis means zero sustainable plant life, which means zero agriculture.
Well, let's not give up, Peter. We haven't asked quite enough questions yet.
For one, why would it start here?
It is the time of the Purinpacha. First came the stars and bored right through the living heart of our world, creating stone and fire, night and day, light and dark. Power, as old as the sun itself, but sent to us to steal the sun away, to bring darkness to the land. In the local Quechua dialect, Pachamama means goddess of the earth, and Purinpacha, I believe, means time of darkness.
But there's no evidence that what this woman's talking about has anything to do with the phenomenon. I think we should run a series of advanced eradication procedures, ELF, positive ions, acoustics.
Flux the environment.
Absolutely.
Should we just discount the folklore angle? I mean, the Spaniards have been writing about this stuff since the 1600s. They recorded the Quechua belief that eclipses had something to do with this time of darkness. I think there might be more to these legends than just fiction.
Tasha, it is intriguing. But at the current rate of expansion, we don't have time to chase down ancient myths. Run the tests. For now, let's go with the ELF. But if all procedures fail, we go with the linear accelerator. File number 77110, case log update. We've tried various eradication procedures, temperature decrease, oxygen removal, and microwave bombardment without success. We are now attempting to flux the environment with ELF transmissions.
...3,900 angstroms and steady. Turn up the frequency.
It's been hours, still no change in the phenomenon.
Prep the PLA. Confirm evacuation of surrounding area.
Curtis. You sure about this?
We have to try every option. Look, I know it's risky, but I don't have a choice. As long as all the civilians are clear.
Well, it's your call. Scares the hell out of me.
The situation is getting pretty tense. Chinese authorities are dealing with it as a military emergency. They've closed the area and expelled all foreign journalists. We're working under extremely close supervision, so there's no time to lose.
We have a green light here for the PLA Bravo team.
Understood.
Stand by, Ningbo. Case manager's log. We've cleared the area of all personnel to protect them from the effects of the portable linear accelerator. Iridation to commence at 0600 hours.
PLA in position. Request clearance to begin countdown.
Commence countdown sequence.
You all set, Peter?
Three minutes till linear acceleration.
Countdown, PLA. We've got a problem.
It's the probe indicators.
Hold on. Remote probe is back online.
Alpha, this is Bravo. Curtis, Bravo team is reporting, but it doesn't make sense.
The phenomenon has disappeared. Copy, Alpha team. The anomaly has disappeared.
Shut the accelerator down now.
Bravo team, confirm. We have not, repeat, not run linear acceleration. Do you copy?
Powering down.
Copy, Alpha team.
Sir, readings fluctuating on all scans of the area.
Let's take a look.
Just like that.
File number 77110. Case manager Curtis Rollins. Final log entry. Theories as to the origin of the phenomenon range from it being a bizarre geological anomaly to the possibility of extraterrestrial phenomena. One theory speculates a rare non-gravitational black hole originating inside the Earth's core, but we have found no conclusive evidence as to how the manifestation actually occurred. Curtis Rollins, out.
Was this phenomenon man-made or truly supernatural? What was this growing blackness? Well, the Office of Scientific Investigation and Research never could determine the exact cause of this amazing occurrence. And was it merely an isolated event, or was it an introduction of something more to come? Perhaps those of us who are afraid of the dark have very good reason to be.
When I talked to you last week, I thought I made that clear. Yeah. No, I know. I know. Because I promised to take my daughter to the park, that's why. Look, why can't you organize a schedule that gives me more than one day off at a time? Look, I have to go. Yeah, I know. I'll see you tomorrow. Bye.
Here you go.
Hey. Do you know what time it is?
With barbecue chips and a chocolate bar.
You've had her candy for supper?
She also had a hamburger.
Time for bed, sweetie. I have to be at work at 7 tomorrow. That means that Lisa has to be at the daycare at 6:30. Mornings are hard enough as it is. You just screwed up her whole sleep schedule.
Yeah, well, if you were a proper mother and had stayed at home, then this scheduling crap wouldn't be a problem, would it? Maybe she'd be better off living with me.
The Office of Scientific Investigation and Research has logged hundreds of hours researching psychokinesis, the ability to move objects without physically touching them. Now, psychokinetic ability would for most of us be an extraordinary gift. But for Elena Bostwick, an overworked single mother, trying to balance the conflicting demands of parenthood and career, this power, which she always took for granted, had become unwelcome. Now, when Elena lost control of her psychokinetic ability, it in fact became an extreme hazard, and it came to threaten the elements in her life which she most deeply cared about, the safety and custody of her daughter, Lisa.
If Brian was my only problem, maybe I could hang on. But nothing much else seems to be going right. With the cutbacks at the hospital, I have to work double shifts. On top of that, I have to be a mother to Lisa. I do the laundry, make the meals. And then every so often, just to antagonize me, Brian, he threatens to sue for custody of Lisa.
Hmm. That must be very upsetting.
He hasn't been part of my life for a long time now. He's never made a single support payment. It's a power trip, his way of getting back at me. Now I'm afraid that if he finds out about it, he'll use it as ammunition to take Lisa away from me. He hates me enough to do that.
He finds out about what?
I can move objects around without touching them, turn things off and on. It's never been a big deal. I've always been able to control it. It's just that a couple of nights ago, things went crazy. Dishes exploded. Glass was flying. Lisa could have been hurt. But you have to believe me, I would never do anything to hurt her.
I don't understand. You move things around?
I've always kept it to myself, especially now with Lisa. I don't want people to think that her mother's odd. You know, some kind of freak.
Do you, hear voices also?
Voices?
Mm-hmm.
Of course not. You think I'm crazy. Psychotic.
Elena, sometimes the mind reacts to stress in odd ways. It runs away with itself. Delusions.
Some medication to calm me down, help keep things under control.
Elena, I would like to help you, but I have never handled anything like this before.
I'm late for work.
Elena, I know of an organization that could analyze this power of yours. Test it.
I work 65 hours a week. I have a little girl to take care of. I don't have time to run off to some lab to be picked and probed. A new radiator.
Cookies.
Lisa, no, not before dinner time, honey.
I want cookies.
No, honey. How about some spaghetti and meatballs, huh? That's a good protein.
Protein.
Oh, no, Lisa, no, not the tomato sauce. Lisa! Dr. Haynes?
Yes.
This is Elena Bostwick. That organization you told me about?
File 10106, case manager Marion Smithick. We're exploring claims of psychokinetic activity by Elena Bostwick, age 31. We're examining the subject's house and immediate terrain. Preliminary interviews are underway to be followed with psychological and physiological assessments.
My daughter's always been special. Had this power, I guess you'd call it, ever since she was a kid. Don't talk about it much. We brought her up better.
One of the surgeons was giving Elena a really hard time. You know, wanted her to be in three places at once. The surgeon really laid into her. Suddenly, the water cooler starts bubbling.
Power like that can mess up a kid's mind real good.
Then the whole tank just exploded. Freaked all of us out, Elena most of all.
I thought she'd kind of forgotten about using it, but lately she says it's been almost out of control, worrying her plenty.
Very convincing.
Now, seismic tests show no anomalous geological activity or disturbances whatsoever. It's as solid as a rock. If things were flying around that house, it wasn't due to any earth tremor.
Dr. Corliss, what's your impression of Miss Bostick?
Excessive workload and being a single mother all adds up to massive personal tension.
Any indication of fraud or hoax?
She seems to be able to control certain aspects of her environment. We still need to determine the extent of her power.
And that glass didn't break from impact. It imploded on its own.
Let's assess her abilities under more controlled conditions. I'll contact headquarters. Set up a test site.
Thanks for taking care of Lisa while I'm gone, Dad.
Oh, she's no problem. You sure you want to do this?
I'm not sure about anything anymore. The only thing I know is that I need help. Professional help.
But you kept it under control before.
Well, it's not under control now. Bye, Dad.
Case log update. After initial testing, we felt it necessary to control Elena's environment down to the smallest detail. A full range of experiments should determine the extent of the subject's power. We'll be using a controlled I.O. chamber to monitor the subject's reactions during intense psychokinetic testing.
All is for me.
Elena, we'll be with you every step of the way.
Case manager Marion Smivik, case log update. We have completed 16 separate phases of psi testing, including physiological and psychological stimuli, altered environments, and electromatrix interaction.
E. L. E. N. A. That's very impressive, Elena.
I used to do this in the playground when I was a child. I spent a lot of time alone as a kid. Dr. Corliss, is that with one S or two?
Two. Thank you very much. But there's something else I'd like you to do for me first.
Standing by.
What's this?
It's for flying debris. We don't want you to get hurt.
I don't understand.
We need to see you consciously create an outburst, implode a cup and saucer like you did at home, and we're going to monitor your biostats.
Oh, okay. If I can.
Anytime you're ready.
Got it on tape.
Your skills are quite powerful.
Have you always had this much control over your PK abilities?
I've never tried to do so many things before.
What we need to know is exactly why the volatile outbursts happen.
We're fairly sure the outbursts stem from various forms of subconscious stress in your life. We're going to run some more tests.
So you can help me?
We will certainly try.
Doctor, with her PK ability, what about a level 9 visual stress test? Mm.
Can she handle that, Doctor?
I believe so. As long as we can regress her into a deep enough hypnotic state.
Then let's proceed. We'll begin tomorrow.
Hi, Dad. I know. I'll pay them when I get home. Oh, and if the hospital calls again, tell them I'll make up my shifts next week. I know it'll have to wait. Brian's lawyer. No, I'll deal with it when I get back. Dad, just stall them. Please? Okay, bye.
Elena, remember, you must try to stay calm. How do these images make you feel? Try to be specific for each picture.
Happiness. Joy. Pride. Love. Sadness. Bitterness. Anger. Resentment. Pressure. Irritation. Frustration. Oh, it's such a hard job. Why won't anybody give me any peace?
It is hard, isn't it? Her heart rate's increasing. Nobody wants to make it easy for you, do they?
I'm doing my best. Oh God, why does it all have to seem so impossible?
Elena, stay focused.
I can't.
Focus.
I can't.
I got an overload here. We got an overload.
Oh, my God!
Everybody watch out! Down!
Your left.
Well, it was worth it in a way. It gave us some insight as to why these events occur. Everyone reacts differently to anger. Your psychokinetic rages are directly linked to stresses in your life.
Check the water pipes for leaks.
It is possible that your subconscious accesses your PK abilities and...
things go nuts.
That's right.
So, can you cure me?
There's really no such thing as a cure. But we can help you to maintain control of your power.
But I want this power gone, eliminated.
Elena, I know the power terrifies you, but it's also a part of who you are. What you have is special.
But I don't want to be special. I want to be a mother and a nurse, a normal person.
File 10106, case log update. Elena has been undergoing stress management training, visualization techniques, combined with meditation exercises supervised by Dr. Corliss. Our goal is to help her find methods by which she can maintain control over her abilities in any given situation.
Bubbles to the surface. Let it go. You are working your third night shift in emergency. They bring in a cardiac patient in severe distress. You immediately prepare 0.5 milligram of digoxin. The attending physician misreads the chart and orders you to administer triple the dosage. He insists. If you speak up, you lose your job. Your daughter's welfare depends on that paycheck. But a patient's life is on the line. What do you do?
I would rather lose my job before allowing a patient to die.
Good. Keep breathing. Out. Two. Three. Four.
All equipment online.
She's worked hard. Let's hope it pays off. This is the big one.
Indeed.
I remember all these faces. My friends. Why, it's been so long since I saw any of them.
And you feel lonely? Deserted?
I do. But it's okay. I have myself and Lisa.
status of being up here?
That's it. Breathe. Open your mind. Good work, Elena.
Case file 10106. Case manager Marion Smithick. Case log update. Day 9. Having successfully completed 20 separate psychokinetic tests and stress reduction techniques, we have concluded that Elena Bostick's ability to control her power is for now within acceptable margins. She has agreed to remain in regular contact with our office.
I agree. Okay. Let's see. Well, orange. That's the color. A nice, gentle cat. Ooh. And how about some little whiskers?
Okay. Okay.
Sweetie, why don't you play in the other room?
Hi, Daddy.
Hey, Lisa.
There is a doorbell, you know. Put that cigarette out.
There you go again, telling me what to do.
When you're in my house, yes.
Suing for custody of Lisa.
Do what you want.
Huh?
You want to take me to court? Take me to court. I have to give Lisa a bath. Close the door behind you.
Through her work with the OSIR, Elena Bostwick learned how to manage her anger and in turn control her psychokinetic outbursts. But far more importantly for Elena, she empowered herself to deal effectively with the kinds of stresses that we all face and ensured that her most precious loved one, her daughter Lisa, will always be with her. I'm Dan Aykroyd for Psi Factor.